is Incendiary Canary.
What's the name of the group?
Couch.
Couch, oh, that's right. Yeah, I went and checked you guys out before I came out here today on the website. Yeah.
Cool.
I thought the.
It was like the funniest moment of the band's life.
just to let you know, you're not going to hear any of the music, but you're going to hear me screaming really loud.
Okay. So
it's going to get pretty deafening in here. Ready to go when you are, Gary.
That sounds
so- Couch came from... well, our band's had a lot of different names. We've had, like, what, six different names?
Six different names.
Yeah, and Couch came across because the day that me and Alex had started just messing around and playing together, we had bought a little blue couch, and we were able to fit, like, nine of our friends on this little blue couch. And when I say little blue couch, I mean that big. And we fit nine people stacking up on top of each other. And so, you know, we went through all these names and everything, and none of them really meant anything to us, but besides that one day that remembered being there with all of our friends and, you know, stuff like that. And so we named it Couch. And yeah, just kind of stuck.
It's been that ever since.
I'm feeling sick now. Need a sit down. Mr. Gray is burrowing. I feel dead, like a stuffed deer head. Fill me up with mayonnaise. Told you they're pretty raw. I'm riding mine, lap of the time. Half eaten gluttony, half benign. They shit in buckets, they hand you pails, feed you. Hey, Gary. What happened to those eight measures we put in? What happened to the eight measures that we put in? Because it's still going into the chorus too soon. And then the last time I was here and we were trying to sing it, I couldn't do it right. And so we worked on fixing the verse to go on a bit longer.
That's how it's supposed to sound. So what happened?
I did the guitar track. It was acoustic, so it was probably pretty hard for you to hear on the phone. And so
well, I did it off of your... You sang it too.
Yeah, and that's what I did it off of when I was playing it. But you went into the chorus too soon, and Brandon followed... He was listening to the drums, followed your lead, and so there was a whole half of the chorus missing. And so what we had to do was go in and take out copy part of the first part, the half of the verse missing. And so we had to go out and copy part of the very first verse and stick that in there and match them up.
Hard to hear, so you guys went into the chorus.
What the fuck?
Like, I have to ask, where's the other wheel?
Oh yeah, I didn't put that on.
Three is not four, and four is only good enough. As a friend, it is my job to take all the very pretty and awesome, clever things that you say and shit all over.
And it's my...
It's my job to do that. Exactly.
It's my job to get pissed and yell at you.
Monday and Wednesday, no matter what's going on, we have those days for band practice. Those are official days, so I don't even need to ask.
Wow. So this tomorrow, we're having practice?
No.
Okay.
No!
We got ideas. Make it a little simpler.
Yeah, Brandon, don't freestyle, dude. Just write something quick and simple.
I'm not freestyling. I'm making it sound good.
Sounds like a freestyle.
We already did all the work on that. First one, Jim. We already did that. Urine. Hey, Gary, is it alright if we hear the song Urine real quick? And make sure that that has enough meat and depth on
it. How do you feel?
That's the most complicated bass line,
though.
Just all of that song.
So, you're agreeing with me now?
Yeah.
Ask Brendan, your opinion, what's the most complicated bass line you've written so far?
I'm not sure. Different bands and
live shots and stuff.
I'm gonna do urine and mustard dog shit. The two excretion songs.
Thank you. By the time I'm done with the smoke, we're gonna move stuff.
Well, can I hit up Subway after we load stuff?
Or you ask my permission. After that, it's all you.
Okay, well, once the van gets here, we don't really have a place to park.
That's where we're going to load.
Yeah. Where's mine?
But I don't want to just, like, go into Subway.
I noticed the two times that we've really played in just random places around downtown Hillsborough, nothing. But whenever we go down to Portland, people come in off the street.
You know? That's because they hear music and they're like, yeah.
Well, I mean, we played at Roseland, right? And at the upstairs, a big stage. And it was empty because the band before us really sucked. So we got up there. I'm sorry, they did. And so we got up there and we started playing. And next thing you know, the room's full. The top whole part is
that's
just people,
huge.
Like, rocking out.
The
I know.
Huge.
It was like full. And then we were like, yes!
Like, I'm just standing there and I'm by myself in front of the stage. And then like 20,000 people come up behind me. What the hell?
Damn. Cool.
Because afterwards, so many people were like, what was your band's name again? Couch. You guys are awesome. Mm-hmm. I love you. Cool. And at first, it started off, we were just kind of messing around, you know? And then we actually started writing songs and started playing shows. So we've been a serious band for maybe three years?
Mm-hmm. Doing pretty good.
Thank you.
I mean, you know, the tempo and groove and everything, it's just, I'm an audio engineer, and you know, I've been in music business for a long time. Your guitars are conflicting with the bass. You can't really tell where the guitar ends and the bass begins. It's kind of drowned out. You know, just look at the cue. I know it's hard for a drummer. I recorded a lot of drummers, but everybody has to go on. They can only play as low as the drummer will go down. So you're kind of stuck.
Yeah.
So it's a real good idea to maybe, instead of going this far back, maybe only go this far back.
That's exactly what we just played.
River Dance?
Oh, yeah. I mean, can you tell? Our River Dance roots in that?
Sure, you hear the chords.
The only way.
The band's here. Shit.
Which is.
Alex, you feeling some snap?
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Damn it, there's a lot.
See, we're just big posers. This is what we listen to normally. I'm really a homosexual. When we roll by black people.
Out in the street, they call it murder.
Rasta!
This is the second tape.
And there's side ones. Like,
yeah, this is what our CD is on right now.
Just one side?
We have
just
about
one
50
side.
Versions.
And
we need to shrink that down to about 15. So yeah,
exactly.
Rasta.
I like the reverb on the snare. Sorry. But I can't hear myself when I talk like this.
What?
A dryer washer is going or something.
Definitely like this one better.
That's Amelia.
Sounds like
fucking
school.
You like it?
Yeah, I do. Or, you okay?
Alex.
I
conscience.
Amelia, version 4. Amelia, version 4. It's the same one you were listening to.
Oh, it was?
It's awesome.
Gong.
Yeah.
Gong at the end.
Neat.
Mm. That's so good. Fucking, how long do I go on for?
That long?
Oh, yeah.
Flipper.
How do we not know?
Yeah, I don't.
Matched up the vocals a lot better. I already like this one better anyways. There's a lot more bottom end. You up the bass a lot. You can hear where I'm saying, kid. I love you. Pass it down, motherfucker. Pass it down.
Can't hear you.
Pass it down.
Pass it.
No.
You helped make the song. It's okay. Straight up, I there's no way I could think of making that better. I'm good with that. Next song? Next song? Or do you want to listen to the other versions?
The other versions. You never know.
Wow.
Never settle.
I say that one.
I want to hear this one too. Lucky 13. I know what song it is. That's great.
Yeah.
Whoa, we hearing it from here, that was like,
go.
He's sexy.
I started playing guitar because I was bored. I was down in Eugene with my dad, and it was my birthday, and I saw a guitar that was really pretty, and I wanted it, and so I basically told him that I would hate him forever if he didn't get me a guitar. And so, yeah, I just kind of collected dust at first, but after that I started picking it up and playing it, and it was a good way to get out anger. So
I basically started drumming because we started this band. Me and Jordan were bored one day, went over to his house, he pulled out his $15 garage sale drum set and started jamming on that, and went over to his house every day and kept playing that thing and liked it more and more every time, and bought my own and done it ever since.
Pretty much, I met these two in Spanish class. They're the class clowns, and I soon joined them. And they're like, hey, we're looking for a bassist, and you can play instruments in band. Do you know how to play bass? I'm like, I can figure it out. So I started out on an Ibanez piece of shit. I don't know. It was just a really bad Ibanez. And we had to borrow my friend's bass amp, and I started out on 2 or 3 notes and got better over time with them. Just playing with them.
We all three started out with pieces of shit equipment.
Yeah.
Was she supposed to be here? 7:30. What time is it? 7:32. I'm gonna take that 2 minutes out of her life.
2 minutes of sex you're not getting back.
Probably 2 minutes of sex I never got in the first place.
I see headlights.
And it's Sam.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right. She's here.
What the hell is this shit?
Okay. It's not shit. It's perfectly fine. You should turn it on and check your tuning right
there. I can't turn it on though.
Okay, then never mind. Was that the morning to where I was sick as hell and so I ended up throwing up in Alex's bathtub?
Yes.
That was that morning?
I think so. When I came back at like 2 or 3, you were like dying.
Yeah, and then Alex is like, let me guess, we're not going to practice, huh? And I was like, kids, my black ass, we're going to practice, whether or not I'm puking. Yeah, it's really hard to sing with fucking chunks of shit in your throat.
Ew. So, what are you doing now?
Good morning!
The long process of Jordan changing one string.
Yeah, no shit. Like, what's up with this thing?
Like, five people.
Okay, seriously? Like, now I'm starting to bug out. You had to say, oh, nothing's gone wrong yet.
I'm sorry. I'm still sorry.
Damn it.
I'm really, really sorry. I'm gonna go cry.
Brandon, where's Alex? Seriously?
Funny story about Alex. Okay. Bye bye, thank you. Funny story about Alex.
Piggyback ride!
Where the hell are you?
He calls me this morning when I'm still in bed at like 7 o'clock. I'm like, dude, you don't need to worry about me. It's all kosher. He's like, okay, fine. So later, my mom and I go to the bank to get $20 for
me. Are you almost here? Okay, good, because we got to go.
What?
All right.
Where's the garbage?
Right there.
All right, later.
That's a garbage can.
Dude, you said you were gonna call him last night and let him know.
I didn't.
He was like, I'm hauling ass back. I'm gonna kick his ass.
I went
to the bank.
I did.
You did. You called him last night.
See,
you
I guess
said
I called him last night because she was there as my witness. My goddess as my witness.
Goddess?
Then I text him later while I'm at the bank while my mom's getting me $20. I said, I'll be there soon. No, I just say, be there soon. And so he thinks that I meant, come be here soon, when I meant, oh, we'll be there soon.
Oh,
so he came out and got me when I wasn't there.
You know what's funny? On the drive over, Sam's like, everything's going to according to plan. This is all working out. And I said, don't.
Shh.
No.
Don't jinx it.
Fuck. Oh, fuck.
Fuck.
I got a dick.
I hate you.
Because I got a ditch? Oh, wait, that.
No,
I got it.
No, because I fucking drove to go and get you and you weren't there.
Wait, did you go to my door?
No.
Where were you?
It's what? Just a beat ass kind of day.
You jinxed
the day.
I'm sorry.
You'll rue the day, man.
I'm ruining.
She'll rue the day she went up against the extreme. Let's get this shit on.
I need to get gas before we head out.
Okay, then let's head out now.
It's like Men in Black in their car.
Step up to new gear or get a limited edition Epiphone Les Paul.
Wonder what he's listening to.
Yeah.
way too much fans and way too many testosterone.
No!
He doesn't even realize how many pictures I've taken of the signs on that street. Wasting his time.
I tried to steal one too.
I don't have the fucking tickets.
Man.
So is she.
Hippie.
Come here. Turn that off.
Oh, and it's fucking cold.
My knees are a bit nicky.
So somebody's gotta run up and get them. All of her tickets are back at my house.
I know the way.
That narrows it down.
To two people?
I know the way.
You wanna go get them?
I'll be here.
You have to leave.
Well, Brandon can drive. 15?
You gotta leave 15.
You only need to turn the 7.
I know, you have to leave 15 there.
Yeah, it's either my car or Sam's car. And Sam isn't gonna let anybody drive.
And then be back.
Well, she's the basis.
So you can't walk in for another hour?
I don't know. Acting like I know more than you, I don't.
You know what I'm acting like? I'm tired.
The game's not tonight.
I want to get in a fight.
That's weird.
You want to watch me get in a fight? Would that cheer you up? Punch the next homeless guy. See? No, I'll get stabbed. But you better be fucking happy.
We could just punch Alex again.
Because it's not the hobo that you find to punch that you should be fearful of. It's the two that are hiding out on the sides. Hey, is there a bathroom in this place?
Yeah, it's wrong.
Did I tell you, if I find a time machine in my lifetime, guess what the first thing I'm doing is? Going and watching Unplugged from Nirvana.
Yeah, for sure.
The second thing, going and watching The Doors. Third thing, going to watch Woodstock. Fourth thing, anything.
No, you know what? I'd find a good fucking Vaseline's concert to go to. Travel back in time and go watch the Vaseline's.
Rolling chair.
Like a bastard.
Try it again.
I didn't expect that. It was just kind of like, bleh. Okay, yeah, that's true.
Oh,
hey, hey.
That was
funny. That's it. Damn. So Ben Noyce is a guy at school that we all hate with a passion. He's like the kind of guy that thinks that he's better than everybody else and that everybody's lower than him because he's one of the cool kids.
Can you tell the story?
And so Brandon was at my house. He pretended to be Ben Noyce. He put
him.
On a big
hold on.
Okay, so I got his acoustic guitar and I go like this. Look, I'm Ben Noyce. Plank! Ben Noyce, your new pair of strings, bro.
Yeah, the guitar string on the high E broke, and so now from now on, Ben Noyce owes me a guitar string.
Oh, that's fucking funny. I didn't know the whole story.
Oh. My dad's supposed to be down here at some point.
Saturday Market?
Yeah. Saturday Market?
Give me the. No, wait. Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool. Hold on, I gotta see the red ones now.
Jordan, you gotta get the white sparkle ones over there.
Which one do you like better? Orange?
I like the red.
You like the red?
Hey, I got one. Thank you guys.
What?
Hey, thank you for being my wall for scratching my feet.
Who's in the giraffe to look at right now?
Well, just like orange and black.
Well, I know, but it's like they have a certain way that they walk.
It's like,
right.
Anime. Wow.
Anime.
what our show.
Yeah.
Oh, I loved it. I mean, when we play, I always fear I'll mess up and someone will notice and sometimes I do make little tiny mistakes, but I don't think I made a single mistake on that set.
I don't think
anyone everything
did.
Was good. The guitar was full and yeah, he was having troubles with the sound and everything, but it was up, the vocals were good, the bass was where I can hear, because that's usually an issue with me, is not being able to hear the bass, and I rely on the bass a lot. But it was good.
I don't think anyone messed up.
Don't moan.
need
the videotaping?
God, yes.
Damn. Oh, crazy. It's like a fucking Mack truck with a camera.
Yeah, I'll turn it right. The light didn't really make.
He's right. Like the kind of stalker that lets you know he's stalking you.
It's like, oh. Yeah, gotcha, weird motherfucker.
Shifty eyed little prick.
Hello.
Whoa.
You're gonna go crazy on stage though, right?
He's going to school, he has to walk.
I might just go to bed.
The worst timing in the world.
I'm in the middle of an interview right now. Two important big bucks are to talk to.
How do you guys feel about couching?
They get better and better.
Wow. Every time. I mean, when we look at the difference between me being in my room with Alex, no cymbal stands, shoved a pole in the wall and hung a cymbal off of it, and not playing any shows and not having all this equipment, and now to what we're at now, I never thought we'd even get this far. I never even thought we'd get half this far.
It definitely feels like we're gonna go somewhere. I mean, people that are wanting to do documentaries on us, getting an entire page in the Argus, getting first and second place in Battle of the Bands competitions.
And that's even all just little chump stuff. I mean,
shows
compared to, I mean, how we all really feel about it, we're willing to eat out of trash cans and stuff to do this. So we're all music lovers.
Yeah.